Hi everyone, in this video, I want to give you an introduction to what rational functions are. In future videos, we will do tons of examples to make sure you fully understand. This video is just meant to give you a broad overview of what they are and why they're important. A rational function is a ratio of one polynomial function over another polynomial function. Here, p1 and p2 are both polynomials. So, we are saying for some input, x, the output, y, or f of x, is going to be the ratio of polynomial 1 to polynomial 2. Before we get too far, let's quickly remember what a polynomial is. The word polynomial, when broken up, is poly, which means many, and nomial, in this context, means terms. Therefore, a polynomial is many terms. A polynomial follows this general formula presented here. In solving these types of problems, there are often a few things that we want to look at and solve for. So, let's go through what those are and give a quick example using rational functions for each. Firstly, we are looking for any input values of x that could allow our denominator to equal 0. These inputs are excluded from our domain, meaning that they are not a valid input to our function, because they do not give us an appropriate output. So, let's say we have this function here. What if x is equal to 2? Well, if x is equal to 2, then this function becomes undefined. And because of this, we know that 2 must be excluded from our example. Another simpler way to do this is we take our polynomial 2 term here and we set that equal to 0. And then we can directly find what inputs will not work due to them turning the denominator to 0. Secondly, we want to know what inputs will make our numerator 0. These are important as they are roots of our function. That is where the function crosses the input or the x-axis, if you will. You can find this in the exact same manner by simply setting the numerator equal to 0, or your polynomial 1 to 0, and then solving for the values of x that are 0. In both cases that we talked about, it is entirely possible to have rational functions that do not have zeros in the numerator or the denominator, and this will occur when you simply have a constant in the numerator or denominator. Thirdly, we need to watch out for areas on our graph where our function is not applicable. And these are called discontinuities. For example, look at this graph here. We have a hole at x equals 2. This means that at x equals 2, there's no output for an input of 2. This is the first way in which we can experience a discontinuity. Just note that even if two terms cancel out like this in this example here, there will still be a hole at the input even though there doesn't appear to be a hole when observing our newly found function. But we know that if we apply, say, x equals 2 to this original equation, we will receive a 0 in the denominator, and therefore have a hole. Another way that a discontinuity can be achieved is through a vertical asymptote. These discontinuities are what we were talking about earlier. Whenever our denominator is going to equal 0, then we have a vertical asymptote. For example, in this equation here, we have a vertical asymptote present at minus 3. The last thing we need to watch out for is horizontal asymptotes. So, what are these? Well, in our vertical asymptotes, these are areas where we don't have a y value for a specific x value. Alternatively, a horizontal asymptote is where our function cannot have a specific y value as an output across any input value. Graphically, this looks like this. Well, what could cause this though? Well, remember back to when we were first learning about polynomials. We talked about the degree of a polynomial, and this is the highest coefficient that is in the power of our x terms in our polynomial. So, in this first polynomial here, the degree of this polynomial is 4, because the highest power on our input term is 4. For this second example, the highest degree is 0, since it is simply a constant. So, to find the horizontal asymptote, there are three scenarios we must consider. Firstly, if the numerator's polynomial's degree is smaller than the denominator's polynomial degree, then our horizontal asymptote is at y equals 0. Secondly, if the numerator's polynomial degree is larger than the denominator's polynomial degree, there is no horizontal asymptote. However, there will be what is called a slant asymptote, which is still a line on a graph where our function will never equal. However, it is going to be at an angle like this. In the next video, I will walk you through how to find these slant asymptotes through long division and synthetic division. So, if you're unsure how to find the slant asymptote, check out that video. Finally, if the numerator's polynomial degree is equal to the denominator's polynomial degree, then we take the coefficient of the numerator's highest term and divide that by the denominator's highest coefficient. So, for example, with this rational function here, there would be a horizontal asymptote at y equals 2. I hope this provided a good introduction to rational functions for you. In the next video, we're going to go through many examples identifying key parts of rational functions and talking more about how you can graph rational functions. So, if you're still confused on any part of rational functions, check out those videos and I'm sure it'll clear up any confusion. Thank you for checking out this video and I hope it helped your understanding of what rational functions are and how we can identify key pieces of information about them. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our Patreon page to support the channel. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.